money. I will make the presentation instead of Cédric Spiller. We will be only present on the fair as of tomorrow. You can meet him then in your booth. I'm going to talk about the use of bacterial poison antidote module for efficient antibiotic-free bioproduction in E. coli. The presentation will take place in two parts. I will start by describing the business presentation, the pre-company history, the profile and activities of the company, and finally, our business model. Secondly, the scientific presentation with E. coli and its issues, the drawbacks of antibiotic markers, then the STABI Express technology developed by Delphi Genetics, the application and benefit of the STABI technology. I will end with the customized services. Starting with the pre-company history. Before the creation of Delphi Genetics, the bacterial poison antidote gene were studied at the Brussels University, and particularly the CCDB poison and CCDA antidote. The first patent on the bacterial CCDB selection was deposited in 1992, and the first publication in 1994. An exclusive license agreement between University of Brussels and In Vitro Gene Company was signed in 1995. The license is now managed by Delphi Genetics. The first cloning kit containing this technology were launched on the market by In Vitro Gene Company in 1995. Since 90 years, Topo, Gateway are the world standard in molecular biology. This picture shows the first version of the cloning vector. This plasmid contains here the CCDB gene and here the selection antibiotic marker. Delphi Genetics is a spin-off of the University of Brussels, founded in 2001 by the inventors of the technology, who are experts in bacterial poison antidote system. Delphi Genetics possesses a broad academic international patent portfolio for key technologies. Delphi Genetics manages the license agreement with In Vitro Gene, more than 250 research kits on the market. Markets of Delphi Genetics is genetic engineering and biopharmaceuticals. Delphi Genetics possesses 12 products with her own brand as STABI Express, and we are also a provider of services in molecular biology. Delphi Genetics employs 15 people, and among them, 5 PhD. Concerning the activity of the company, there are 3 types of incomes. Firstly, Delphi Genetics is an expert service provider for gene expression, DNA cloning, and recombinant protein production. Secondly, Delphi Genetics sells research kits for molecular cloning and protein expression based on proprietary technologies. The products are sold directly by Delphi Genetics and distributed globally via a distribution network. The third income is the licensing of the technology for biopharmaceutical application. The STABI technology can be used in a project from laboratory scale to industrial processes. The STABI operating system is very flexible, and its element can be integrated into your favorite tools. The STABI kit can be used to test the STABI technology. From the research until the clinical stage. And this step, a license agreement is required. Currently, STABI Express is non-exclusively licensed to Sanofi Pasteur, GlaxoSmithKline, and Merck. Let's turn now to scientific presentation. E. coli is still the workhorse for molecular biologists. It's an excellent tool for intracellular production, proteins, and plasmid DNA. E. coli possesses several advantages as the low cost, it's a robust tool, and high titers are achievable. The problem encountered with E. coli is the use of antibiotics. Antibiotics are used during DNA cloning for recombinant clone selection and during production for plasmid stabilization. The antibiotic-resistant gene is present on the plasmid contains the gene of interest. During the bacterial growth, antibiotic molecules are formed everywhere, outside and inside the bacteria, with the aim to killing the bacteria which don't possess the plasmid anymore. There are three issues with the antibiotic use. Firstly, the antibiotic preparation contains impurities. Secondly, the antibiotic resistance marker could potentially be spread in the environment. Finally, the resistant gene marker is present on the molecule used. In bioproduction, there are three drawbacks of antibiotics marker. Firstly, only few markers are tolerated by the regulatory authorities. As example, for vaccinal DNA or therapeutic recombinant proteins. Total absence of antibiotic need to be achieved in the final product. Secondly, the environmental issue, the use of antibiotics in large fermenters and the generation of bacteria harboring resistant gene could be problematic. Thirdly, antibiotic resistant gene represent a burden of energy for the bacterial host, leading to a decrease of productivity, therefore not always compatible for production of difficult protein. Thus, an alternative to antibiotic markers is needed to make bioproduction in line with regulatory iteratory suggestions and to increase the production yield. Some slides with the recommendation made by the regulatory, e-recommendation made by the FDA in 1998 to avoid the use of antibiotic selection marker to protect the environment, and suggesting the use of non-antibiotic selection system. Already in 1996, another example on the website on the FDA for therapeutic recombinant DNA and for monoclonal antibody production with the obligation to remove antibiotics. The same recommendation for vaccine production. The European Agency made the same recommendation about impurity and here about the resistance marker to antibiotics present on plasmid DNA. This paper illustrates the third drawback. The antibiotic-resistant gene represents a burden of energy for the bacteria. This study, performed in collaboration with GlaxoSmithKline, shows that bacteria yield can decrease according to the sequence present on the DNA, on the plasmid DNA. Delphi Genetics has designed a novel and highly effective stabilization system called StabiExpress technology, based on the use of post-segregational killing gene, so-called poison antidote gene or selection modules. A selection module is typically organized as an operon. The StabiExpress technology is based on the CCDA system and is composed of two genes, an antidote CCDA and a poison called CCDB. These genes are naturally found in plasmid and bacterial chromosome. The CCDB gene selects, the CCDB selection gene codes for a small stable protein, which is toxic for E. coli by acting on the DNA gyrase. Note that this enzyme doesn't exist in eukaryotes. The CCDA antidote gene codes for a small unstable protein that neutralizes the toxic protein both transcriptionally and via protein-protein interaction. The STABI technology is a powerful alternative to antibiotic marker for clone selection and plasmid stabilization. Some point to explain the principle of this technology. The poison is integrated in the bacterial chromosome. The promoter of the poison is repressed by the antidote. The antidote gene is located on the plasmid. Thus, the bacteria losing the plasmid will die as the action of the poison is not inhibited. This system creates an addiction to the plasmid without antibiotics. The stabilization is purely based on genetic elements. The STABI technology can be applied to bioproduction of protein and plasmid DNA. The plasmid stabilization illustrated here by a picture. In red, the CCDB gene located on the chromosome. Here, the CCDB present. In green, the CCDA gene located on the plasmid. And here, the CCDA protein. During the bacterial growth, the CCDA protein inhibits the transcription of the CCDB and inhibits the toxic effect by interacting with the CCDB protein. If the plasmid is lost, the antidote protein is degraded and the production of the poison is induced, causing cells' death. This system allows the perfect plasmid stabilization without the use of antibiotics. Here's the map of a basic STABI vector. It's a PET vector backbone to which the CCDA gene has been added. It's compatible with the current expression system, including T7, the recent resistant gene marker to antibiotics. The strains containing the CCDB gene have been fully sequenced. An example to illustrate the protein production application is the production of a non-toxic bacterial protein. The production level is 3 to 5 times higher using the STABI expression system in lane 8 than in the case of a conventional system SBL21 showed in lane 9. This table comes from the study performed by Sanofi Pasteur to evaluate the antibiotic-free system developed by Delphi Genetics in fermenters. When standard conditions are applied, the plasmid maintenance is equivalent when the poison antidote is compared to the standard vector, 98% versus 90%. But the amount of expressed protein is twofold increase with the poison antidote system. In artificial high stress, the plasmid loss is rapid with the standard vector as compared to poison antidote, 5% versus 100%, indicating the very stringent selection of the CCDA-CCDB system. The tenfold difference in the amount of expressed protein is fully consistent with the observed difference in terms of plasmid maintenance. The last application of plasmid stabilization is plasmid DNA production for vaccinal DNA, for example. The DNA extraction is 5 to 10 higher using STABI Express, showed in lane 2 or 4, than using a typical E. coli strain in line 1 or 3. Some point to summarize the benefit of the STABI technology. First, no need to use antibiotics in the production processes, therefore meeting regulatory guidelines. The STABI Express system works with animal-free medium. The stabilization technology is based slowly on genetic elements and is rediscalable. The process is easily transferred from R&D to industrial scale fermentation, thus creating an integrating platform for the production of biomolecules in E. coli. all bacterial strains are fully sequenced, thus a complete traceability. Delphi Genetics can customize any vector or E. coli strain with the STABI technology. Finally, the higher yield of F-expressed protein or DNA due to perfect plasmid stabilization and limitation of the burden of energy. I will finish with the customized services in DNA engineering and protein production. We can help you from gene synthesis to protein production. These services are based on the know-how acquired by Delphi Genetics in these domains. We can work with the STABI technology or with your own tool. We can perform all these steps, gene synthesis, codon optimization, subcloning, plasmid DNA preparation, direct mutagenesis, qPCR analysis, and optimized protein production. Separately, or from gene synthesis to protein production, in for pharma or non-pharma application. Finally, we can help you from genome sequencing to strain or antibody development. Delphi Genetics possesses a next generation genome sequencer. We can perform viral or bacterial genome sequencing and then perform genetic modification to customize your bacterial strains. All bacterial strains present in your research kit are completely sequenced by this technology. The LicePoint is currently in development and it's based on an interesting way to present the antigen of the cell surface. Here is a picture of your new building, which we have been occupying since spring. If you have any question, you can meet us in your booth there. Cédric Spirer will be present as of tomorrow. Thank you for your attention.